Dexter's here.
LifeQuest continues with me, Moses Tinsley, your clinical psychologist. Don't hesitate to go on our Facebook page. It's called Moses Tinsley LifeQuest TV program. And you'll be able to ask us any question, medical and or ever, that deals with your functionality, the function of your body, how you think, how you process things. And if you're gonna fall into the people I'm going to mention or the categories of the symptoms that I'm going to mention, on our first session, I shared with you how all these things work together and how our information, how the environment we get exposed to determine the development of our minds, the development of our brains. Well, some people say that people look like the job they work. If you go to a taxi park, sometimes they behave like the same type of people. And you know what? I've felt that many times. You go just and see people, the borders are in a company or something like that, in an office, artists. There is a language, there's a sequencing of things, the way people behave and the way people communicate in some settings. And these people are not related at all. And you'd be like, aba boda mwebe bamu, or aba taxi mwebe bamu. Yeah, like many times we equate people, or we identify people by how the environment, or they are by the environment of their place of work. Why? Because their brains develop according to the environment and the surrounding. So be cautious. What are you surrounding your brain with? What are you feeding your brain? What are you giving access to your brain? What are you allowing to invade your brain? Because whatever you give your brain takes it in. The toxic and non-toxic. So, just an advice, don't leave what you're not. Don't try to force things out. Don't try to struggle to prove a point. Just be you. You don't have to respond to everything and everybody. You don't have to be the best person, the perfect person at the place of work. You're just not going to be that angel with all the work, the work team around you. Just be you. Do what is supposed to be done and things will just be okay. Because the more you're trying to prove a point, the more you're trying to fix stuff and you're all on doing that pressure so that you can cope up with the system at your new job, you know what? It breaks you down. So, what are the signs and the symptoms of a depressed person? Unfortunately, we have all these people all over us, and sometimes it's you I'm talking to. So don't go far. Keep your TV, your station tuned in as I share these brilliant ideas and the technical know-how as a clinical psychologist. Don't forget to rush on Facebook and let's grow our audience. Let people know that we're here every Friday of the week, first Friday of the month and the last Friday of the month. We are here, I'm here with you. And for those who are our obedient, loyal followers, thank you so much. Let's dive in to the signs and symptoms of a depressed person. Depression varies from person to person, but there are common signs and symptoms. It is important to remember that these symptoms can be part of someone's life's normal laws. You know, normal laws. Sometimes when things are not working good, I just want to go sleep. I want to spend time alone. I want to be alone and stuff like that. You know, it's normal, but that is depression. You're depressed. You want to go and give your brain a different atmosphere, a different environment, so you can process issues. Yeah. Depression sometimes can just, you know, it varies. For some people, it just blows up. The polarization level goes high, and some people know how to really deal it down so that the curve goes down into depolarization. Because as I told you from the first session, our brains are connected with billions of neurons, and neurons are messengers that transmit the information given to your body, to your brain, through the senses, through the things you touch, the things you see, and I mean every information that you receive. So the neurons speak the language that you give them. Give them the sad language, they'll speak that. You keep it fiery, they send fire. That's the craziest part. If you can't just hold it, if you're given that bad information, that bad news, neurons will reflect that and the system will jump. Find yourself self-collapsing. Let's look at this, a few symptoms, because there are very, very, very many. How do you know that someone is depressed? Number one, when someone feels hopeless and helpless. You know, there's a state where someone will just communicate and say, I don't feel like this is gonna work. I don't feel like I can restore this relationship. I've done my best, but I think I'm losing it. I think I'm failing. So you know that such statements tell you that this person is depressed. Number two, loss of interest in daily activities. And that means, for example, you do not create time for your former hobbies or social activities, and you've just lost your ability to feel joy and pleasure. You just lost it, and man, you don't feel like hanging out with anybody. You don't feel like waking up and plan for a weekend or plan for something else out there. And yeah, so it changes, and if it changes, your activities change. So loss of interest in daily activities, when someone changes that, just know there's something happening. It might be social, it might be relational, even in marriage, when someone doesn't feel like is being drawn to the intimate affection, the romantic attraction. So you just know that this person is basically depressed. And once again, depression is a disease. You don't have to forget that. But I bring this to you from a professional point of view, so that you might be able, probably not know how to deal with this in case you're a victim, or you fall to be a victim, or your friend, or your ever relative. So your appetite, another symptom, appetite our body weight changes. Yeah. Basically, when someone is depressed, you can know. I don't know how to call this in Luganda, but many people in this time of pandemic, they are struggling because their businesses have gone low. They can't afford to feed their families. They can't keep their relationships. Students are not going to school, and some are supposed probably to graduate and have ambitions and targets. Absolutely, yes. And all these are huge to deal with, to handle. What happens? I'll tell you how we can get out of this. So, I'm just giving you symptoms today. So, loss of appetite and weight, that is a symptom that someone is depressed. You will know that someone is depressed by loss of appetite and change of weight. You'll know that someone is depressed when this person is constantly developing anger and irritability, feeling agitated, restless, or even violent. When someone is depressed, some kind of personalities, their level of tolerance becomes very low. The temper becomes so short, and everything and everyone gets on your nerve. Everything and everyone, now get out of my way. Your level of tolerance becomes pretty low because you don't want to reason out things. You're depressed. When the inside of you, remember as I told you from the first session, when the inside of you is chaotic, definitely the outside results, the external output becomes affected. Your relationships become affected. Your conduct and absolutely your character might be affected. And the more the outside also gets affected, you continue to break down and deteriorate in your dreams, in your goals, in your targets and values in your life. So loss of energy, feeling fatigued, sluggish, and physically drained. Your whole body may feel heavy, and even small tasks are exhausting or take longer to complete. Yeah, I've been a victim, and I'm glad I chose to go this direction. I loved it because I've grown through all these developments in life, from my childhood to where I am, and as a clinical psychologist, I'm still pursuing to become a neurosurgeon. And you know what? Because I want to go deep into these scientific solutions and basically be a help to the people around me, and probably we make a better world wherever we can. We can, yes, we can. Well, so I was telling you that I've been a victim of this loss of energy. I mean, just feel like you can't run your stuff, and even just driving and getting out of your house to drive, man, it becomes like, oh, this is heavy. I just want to keep in the house. I don't know what I want, but I want to be in the house. I don't want to move anywhere. And this can be so crazy in a way that you don't even want to get out of your bed to just go and grab a drink from your own refrigerator. And, you know, anything can become impossible when you are loss of energy. So you feel fatigued, you feel sluggish, physically drained. Your whole body may feel heavy, and even small tasks are exhausting and or take longer to complete. Know that you are struggling with depression. And self-loathing. Self-loathing are strong feelings or worthlessness or guilt. You harshly criticize yourself for perceived faults and mistakes. You need to learn how to forgive yourself. And so if you don't know how to deal with this, you might end up judging yourself, feeling unworthy. And this is where people get broken down, and when they feel like no one, they are not seeing a solution around them, no one is really, you know, the funniest thing about depression is that we even don't know how to explain it to the people close to us sometimes, and we don't have a name to give it. You know, I struggled with depression not knowing that that was depression. Yes, you can be struggling with depression not knowing that actually you're dealing with depression. So that is very, very, very dangerous. So feelings of worthlessness or guilt, you feel like, I think what people are saying, I think what my parents are saying, I think what my husband is saying, I think what my children are saying is true. I'm not a father enough. I'm not a husband enough. I'm not a wife enough. I'm a mother enough. I'm a friend enough. I'm not a celebrity enough. I'm not that best artist. I'm not that best worker, best employee. I'm not worthy. I'm not accepted. All those feelings, they tell you that you're depressed. And so we'll definitely briefly share how you can navigate through this. And so just keep tuned in, and definitely you'll know how to handle this and how to help your life to be able to be sober, to achieve your dreams and definitely achieve your targets. Concentration problems. You got trouble. I mean, this is another symptom. If you want to know that you are depressed, you'll have that problem. You don't concentrate really well, and this might be trouble in focusing. And someone who's depressed, it can easily cause an accident when driving, because they do not even concentrate on their driving. That's why someone who's depressed, if you have a friend or a wife or a husband and you know that you're depressed, please do not drive. I recommend that you do not drive if you know that you're having trouble concentrating, and because that will definitely be dangerous. I once was a victim. I was driving and I was depressed. And when you're depressed, you lose focus. And when you lose focus, you kind of lose yourself. And so by the time you get back to yourself, to your normal senses, after that lapse, something bad might happen. Because when you are having trouble concentrating, that means you're having memory lapse. Something is not adding up in your brains. And if something is not working out right in your brains, maybe they are planning to lay you off your job, or your girlfriend is threatening to get it done, or your boyfriend, or your money that you've been expecting kind of getting some twist, or your business has been hijacked, and something like that. You know, when you know that you are having instant emergencies or quick emergencies, or something that you're struggling with that has prolonged, and you're driving I encourage you to find someone to drive you. It will save you, save your life, and save your dreams. Yes, this is very ideal. Because when you are failing, you're losing, you're having concentration problems, your focus fails, your focus level becomes very low. Your ability to make sober and right decision goes down. So don't make decisions when you're depressed, because you're going to make permanent decisions for temporary situations. Don't make decisions when you're depressed, because you're not healthy. You're sick. You need to fast away. You need to fast get through a series of changes, or medication, or help, professional help, or something of the sort, like someone who will be watching us and following us as we bring different people on board. You'll be able to get some ideas, you'll be able to get some remedies on how you can achieve this. And as I began from the beginning, I told you the brain is the master controller of everything we say and do. And I gave you the simplest, easiest solution, remedies to begin with. Feed your brain what you want it to feed you, because whatever you give it, it will feed you. And when it feeds you, your body will react to it positively or negatively, thus influencing your outside world. So that is just but one of the things that are going to be highlighted during this program and many other programs that will be coming. Keep watch, keep following us on Facebook, knowing which days we are online and which days we'll be broadcasting. So hit us, send us, just drop in your questions, Facebook, on Moses Tinsley Life Quest TV programs. Just go there and like the page. Send us any question. Confidentiality is our first priority. If I'm not going to answer you that, I have my friends, the neuropsychologists and many other people around me, and basically we'll be able to come up with solutions to help you. So don't make decisions when you're having trouble to concentrate, because you're not sober, you're sick. So another thing is, under concentration is you fail to remember things when you're depressed, because you cannot concentrate, you cannot put the threads together, you cannot make this work out. So you have trouble remembering. So on our next session, I'll be helping you and any other person that you'll invite in to know how to overcome depression and the remedies that are at your disposal, that you're with them and will help you. When another symptom is unexplained aches and pains, an increase in physical complaints such as headaches, back pain, aching muscles, and stomach pain. See how much depression can cause. Remember, I told you from the beginning that our brains have billions of neurons, and these neurons are the messengers that take information to the brain, feeding the central nervous system, which is the spinal cord. And you know that the spinal cord is the center of everything. If you lose it, then you're losing life. And so unexpected pains coming because the neurons have received the fiery information. And I told you, fiery information is any information that is negative, any information that your brain has not been used to, strange information, ugly information, sad information that surrounds you or around you or around your environment. And this causes headaches, stomach aches, and so many things. There are remedies. Of course, you can do painkillers and everything, but the greatest thing is to realize that the diagnosis is you're depressed. And the last one I'm going to give you before I leave this is reckless behavior. When someone is depressed, sometimes they engage themselves into reckless behaviors. And some will venture into substance abuse, compulsive gambling, reckless driving, or dangerous sports. So this is all in your hands. On our next session, we'll be learning how we can get out of this ditch and how we can avoid falling in the ditch. You know what? We need this every day. We need this everywhere. The rich or the poor, celebrity or a normal person, you need this. Don't miss our next episode, our next session. You're going to get the light in the path of your dreams. Don't forget to subscribe on our Facebook page and my YouTube channel, Moses Tinsley. You'll be able to get more updates concerning this program.